So we turn our attention to the final, second final of the day, final of men's singles. After that straight game victory for world champions Matsumoto and Nagahara, none of the players, neither AVIHINGSANON nor Rasmus GEMKE, have previously won a world tour. Victor Axelsen is the only Dane who's won a world tour yet. Won the Malaysia Masters. Here is the race to Guangzhou, the world tour ranking, and as we can see, Suppanyu number 7 on that tour, whilst Rasmus GEMKE is currently ranked 35th on the world tour ranking. One Thai that has won on the Super 100 tour, that's Sitikom Tamasin. Here we can see the road to the final. AVIHINGSANON has been absolutely dominant throughout all his games, straight game victories, whereas Rasmus GEMKE has struggled in the quarterfinal against AJ Jaram, was behind one game down, and down at the interval in the second game, but suddenly found his game and went on to win, and eventually got revenge over Toby Penty in the semi-final. So court officials just entered the arena. Here he is, the top seed from Thailand, Suppanyu AVIHINGSANON. This final is his best result of his career so far. Never won a tournament, AVIHINGSANON. Here's Rasmus GEMKE, the Danish youngster. Got his breakthrough last year when winning the 2017 Bitburger Open, beating Suk Jin Hao on the road to victory. And also, as you can see, beat AVIHINGSANON in a hard-fought three-game match.
This side, so we receive.
So, change events. GEMKE was it's on the back of that to win in Bitburg Open, and some good results in early tournaments of the year, where he reached the quarterfinal in Indonesia Masters, selected at the expense of Hans Christian Wittinghus to play the European Championships to give him extra exposure. Selected by the coaches, Danish coaches, and reached the quarterfinal, lost to Victor Axelsen. Here is top seed, born in Bangkok. Currently, as you saw, ranked 7th on the world tour. Played the world championships lately and lost the first round to Anthony Ginting, but his performance here in Barcelona has been absolutely spotless. Straight game victories in every match. Quite easy victory against Uri Garashi, who had ousted Danish veteran Janu Jorgensen. But still, Danish interest in the final through this man here.
Both expecting to have their first win in the World Tour.
Rasmus GEMKE was coming of the year in 2012 in Danish badminton. Comes from the same club as Anders Antonsen, so two big talents. And some of them groomed by former Chinese Thomas Copper, Jiang Cheng.
Ready to play?
Played eight tournaments so far this year and has sort of moved up a level from playing international and challenges to going up to play Super 500s. Here's our umpire, Asa Salberg, Sweden. Ginger Moreno takes care of the services. So, very interesting to see whether it's AVIHINGSANON looked really good yesterday in the semi-final, or GEMKE that sort of found form in the quarter-final against AJ Jairam, one of them who will win their first World Tour.
Who will it be? Play.
Attack from AVIHINGSANON. He's heavily strapped on his lower leg. Basically an attacking player, GEMKE, but I suspect he's about to develop his game so he can be a little bit more patient. Played solid yesterday against Toby Penty. Chance to take three titles here in Barcelona. And the four nations have done that before on the World Tour. Japan has twice won three titles in Thailand Open and German Open, whilst Thailand in the Thai Masters won three, and China on home soil. Sorry, that's duck information. China in US Open also won three titles. Super 100 Tour. China won four titles at home in Ling Shui Masters. Thank you. rally. Oi. Totally missed that one. AVIHINGSANON.
Well
played, and GEMKE and his coach. Is something that they discussed. Coach is Jesper Haugaard, formerly assistant coach in France, now Danish under 19 national coach. Excellent smash placement by AVIHINGSANON. Rasmus GEMKE had been trying to sort of move up in terms of tiers, tournament tiers. That also goes for AVIHINGSANON. And of course, sometimes costs some early exits.
5-8.
Four times this year as he lost the first round. The Asia Championships to Suppanyu and Malaysia to Lee Hyunil. And then Anthony Ginting of the World Championships. So really, really nice to get some matches under his belt here for the top-seeded Thai player. Oi, fantastic deception, but overdid it. Look at this.
6-9.
Make it seem like a straight shot, and then just before hitting the shuttle, change the direction of the racket head.
6-7-9.
Over. 10-7. Oi, lucky net court.
Service
over. For Rasmus GEMKE. 3-point lead going into the mid-game interval here in the first game,
11-8. Please refrain from using flash with your photographs. Thank you very much.
Twenty seconds. Thank you, coach. Rasmus.
So, ready to
11,
resume play?
Play.
AVIHINGSANON with the 3-point advantage.
Service over. 9-11.
He's been conducting most of the rallies, the man in the picture here in the first game so far, but only 2 points up. Wait, something is hit. It's playing very short, AVIHINGSANON. There's one place you don't want to be short, that's when you play the net. Because then it's a direct point for your opponent.
10-11.
28 shots that rally. Great net play.
Service over. 12-10.
Yeah, you're not allowed to put your racket up to block your opponent's shot. Like we saw Rasmus GEMKE did here. Important phase here. Is GEMKE on his way back in this first game here, or Can AVIHINGSANON benefit from the way he's played so far?
Service over.
Reached the final of Vietnam Open in 2017. Did AVIHINGSANON lost to Fed Pradap.
12-13.
GEMKE recently reached the final of Orleans Masters, the Super 100 tournament, but lost to Mark Cajo. As well.
15.
Good variation in his smashes, AVIHINGSANON. Foot placement makes it difficult for him to return a shot to the forehand. Great awareness by AVIHINGSANON. Excellent placement, fantastic rally by AVIHINGSANON, and his coach behind the court give him two thumbs up. Very satisfied.
17-12.
And why shouldn't he be? He looks in great balance, AVIHINGSANON, whilst GEMKE is struggling a little bit more, discussing a little bit with his coach what to do. Smash placement there from GEMKE, and the run of 4 points for AVIHINGSANON is stopped.
17.
Shuttle had gone missing.
13-17.
At the umpire's chair. Good save.
Service over.
Yeah. More or less a 2-point shot. From Gemke, that one. He was talking about yesterday that his legs were feeling a little bit heavy. Gemke. Question is whether the wind helped on the legs or it's still there. Slippery on Avihingsanon's court there, so of course wants it mopped. This diving defense. And he's been closing the Dane down so far. Excellent shot, very, very short racket movement there, or the arm movement, the racket movement was absolutely fine. That sets up 7 game points for Avihingsanon. Nice placement, not so hard to smash, but the placement was more than enough to score the point. I think that could be the way forward for the Dane. That's gone wide, and after 21 minutes, Salberg confirms 21-15 here in the first game.
Second game. Level.
So Rasmus GEMKE will have to come from one game down if he wants to win his first World Tour title. Whilst AVIHINGSANON, he's sort of continued where he left yesterday. Won his ninth straight game in this tournament here. Good placement.
To love.
Oy, good deception by the Dane. AVIHINGSANON parked in the middle. Also, one of the questions, how will it affect the top seed if he's about to win his first international tournament at age 28? Good shot. A little bit of slice. And the shot from GEMKE. Done it. Too low quality on the drop shot from the Dane. Easy for AVIHINGSANON to be precise on the next shot. It's a great deception, but it's gone long. Pity that he overdoes these shots. Rasmus GEMKE, he's got a 6-1 lead and he can afford to be a little bit more patient now. Two easy mistakes. Big mistake as well.
7 3.
They're going for the lines, the two players. This time he was successful. I mean, he's on. I think they can afford to play with a little bit of margin. Well played, two drop shots in a row from Gemke. It's a strange looking one, the last one.
9-4.
But did the damage. It seems like AVIHINGSANON often moves. Likes to move away from the front court early to get himself in a good position to attack. I think this is going Gemke's way. It's easy to say when he's leading 10-4 in the second, but he's one game down, but right now he looks to be in the driving seat here. Yeah, well played. 7 points advantage for Rasmus Gemke. Convincing here in the second game, and a little bit disappointing by AVIHINGSANON. He looked so good in the first. We're discussing, but it seems like long drop shots from Gemke will neutralize AVIHINGSANON. Excellent play. Played downwards to the front court a couple of times.
13.
Get AVIHINGSANON to turn when he's going to the back court, and things looked quite a bit easier than the first game. Perfect. Yeah, that's well placed.
Service over.
So it was like GEMKE said, okay, I want to try play the backcourt. Well, that's what happened. And you lost the rally. Sometimes the players sort of can't believe that it's possible to do what they've discussed with their coach in the interval. Thinking, if I play the front court again, my opponent must cover it. But that's not always the case. And very often the difference between a good player and a champion. Excellent shot. Excellent shot. It's the same shot played to the other side. The downward
40,
drop shot or slow smash that stops a little bit ahead of AVIHINGSANON, and he can basically challenge at the net afterwards, Rasmus GEMKE, because he doesn't have the correct quality, AVIHINGSANON. He's gone totally off boil. AVIHINGSANON, of course, letting this second game go. 11 points down. There, a little chance you come back here. Gone long. It was a situation where GEMKE was having a really, really good position, and
five.
It looks like he thought, hey, I'm not supposed to hit it really hard here. What am I going to do? And he can hit it hard, in my opinion. It's just going to be towards the body of his opponent. It's gone wide and long.
18-5.
Worried look on the coach's face. First of 15 game points survived. But I think mentally, the two players, they're already thinking about the third and deciding game. There it is. Game. Second game to Rasmus GEMKE in double quick time. 21-6. The second last smash and the follow-up. One game all.
Så må jeg også tage fra start, så det er kun 0-0 igen.
Ja.
vægt på dem. Så gør du kom sådan op. Ja. Så det stod en af dem. Okay. Så vær klar på, når du angriber fødderne op i hæld, så kommer han ligger til at vinke dig. Okay. Er noget på det, at du bliver
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
Danes discussing that Coach Jesper Holger would like to see a clear once in a while, especially from the round the head side, because he feels that if Gemke is attacking straight, then AVIHINGSANON will just move him to the other side, and I think that's correct. But again, one of the solutions, in my opinion, just play downwards to the front court. But let's see if AVIHINGSANON comes out better than in the second game. Let's hope for him that he does, because otherwise he's in dire straits. Again, he moves away from the net. The top-seeded player from Thailand is going wide. Net shot. And great follow-up by Rasmus GEMKE. AVIHINGSANON is down and can only watch. Six shots.
One,
he did well to get that back. That's too wild. There's no need to go for the lines there from a Danish perspective. Just play downwards. That's a big miss. Got some bright lights here in the Olympic Stadium in Bali de Bron. I don't know if sometimes it disturbs the players a little bit. That's a great raid by Rasmus GEMKE. As you can see, he touches the net, but it's after the shuttle has landed. It was actually a close call there. But if the rally is over, then you're allowed to touch the net. So that's the decisive factor. Has the shuttle touched the ground? It's a good smash by AVIHINGSANON, but there's lots of room on the front court for GEMKE to play back it. AVIHINGSANON, that one there, even though he's way below the tape, he can easily play straight drop. Should have seen by now that the top seed likes to move backward really quickly. Like he's gone away, the Dane, from what worked for him in the first or in the second game. Wow. Looked like it could have been long, that lift from GEMKE there. Almost both feet outside of the court. AVIHINGSANON. Three big, big opportunities that he's missed from that backhand corner, AVIHINGSANON. Serve a little bit faster, not in terms of time, but put more speed into the shuttle so it came closer to AVIHINGSANON. Excellent. Wait until the shuttle is crossed over the net. Not allowed to make the initial contact on the opponent's side, of course, but he's allowed to finish his stroke on the opposite side of the net. Another missed smash, but a challenge from AVIHINGSANON. Let's see what Hawkeye says. Yeah, he was out. Half of the point Rasmus GEMKE has scored has actually been scored by AVIHINGSANON in a favorable position. Surely he won't be satisfied when he watches this game back on video. Gets one back from Gemke. Of course, the court needs to be mopped. The top seed was diving. Time he got the right calibration on his smash placement. Of course, a lot more focus on the front court in this third game. Second drop shot is totally gone from the Danes game here in the third. Shot. Excellent placement on the right hip of Gemke. Sharp net play. Takes the top of the net court and comes almost unreturnable. Oy, that's a good deception, but Rasmus GEMKE is really lucky that it goes long. He is moved in the wrong direction. Yeah, he wants him to. Espahogo wants GEMKE to put more speed in his service, then he will play the backcourt. Good lift.
11, 9,
and a 2-point advantage for the 20-year-old Dane. Here is the players change ends at the interval in the third game. Thank you.
11-9. Play.
So, last break of the match. Great smash placement. Again to the right hip. Definitely done a much better job in playing back at Gemke on the front court as AVIHINGSANON. Both players got to better their error rate on the smashes. I mean, it's just gifting points to your opponents, and both are trying to sort of establish themselves on the higher levels of the World Tour, and there's lots of tension on here. Good save. Excellent lift. Oi! A sitting defense, he fell on his way backwards, AVIHINGSANON. How unlucky is that? Look here. The dive gets up and falls in his own sweat.
13-11.
That's how dangerous it is. And of course, Gemke cleverly directs the next smash, where the perspiration was on the court. Things talking about the. Since it's a new shuttle, he probably will try and play the net. AVIHINGSANON. Let's see if Gemke is going to challenge. I think he might go for a kill.
Play.
The question is, if you give away your idea by moving too quickly, it's too easy for your opponent to lift, like it happened there. Excellent play by the Dane. He was looking for that
14-11
possibility on the front court. Four straight points for Gemke. Great rally by the two players, and eventually AVIHINGSANON converted his attack. Good follow up there.
On court.
Just about to cross the hour mark for this men's singles final. Oh, that's a mistake. It's called in, but I'm sure that the challenge will reveal that it was indeed wide. Or did it catch just a tiny fraction of the line? No, no, it didn't. Experienced most of the linesmen in this tournament here in terms of judging badminton at this pace. Excellent smash from Gemke, a long, long smash.
16-13.
Close to the back line. Outside the picture, Suppanyu AVIHINGSANON is getting rid of his tapings on his lower leg.
16-13. Play.
Good drop shot. Excellent play. Gemke celebrating. Two shots in the same direction. Did the damage to AVIHINGSANON. First singles for his country in the Thomas Cup did AVIHINGSANON beat Brian Yang from Canada and then lost in three games to Sohwan Ho from Korea. Gemke wasn't selected for the Danish team. Looking at court here, and now 5 points advantage for the 21-year-old Dane. On the drop shot there, and an easy kill for AVIHINGSANON. Lots of tension now on the court, I suspect. Another good smash. Almost the same placement as four or five rallies ago. Touches down just before the back line.
14.
That smash sets up six match points for the 21-year-old Dane.
Match point 14.
Can win his first ever World Tour tournament. His first tournament since Bitburger Open last November. And there it is.
Game.
It's gone long, and Rasmus GEMKE is the first champion in men's singles of the first edition of the Spain Masters 2018. He came back from one game down against the top seed, Suppanyu AVIHINGSANON. From the beginning of the second game, he was actually the dominant player on court. The young Dane. Let's hear what he's got to say to our interviewer.
To play here the whole week in front of the crowd, so thank you.
What are your expectations for this year?
Yeah, I think in 2 weeks I will go to Asia and play for three tournaments, which I'm looking really forward to right now, and try to win a match there. That's the goal. That's the goal.
Tak, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Rasmus nos ha comentado que dentro de tres semanas va a hacer la gira asiática con tres torneos.
And it's of course the Japan Open Super 750, the China Super 1000, and the Korea Super 500 that Rasmus GEMKE is talking about. When asked about what his next goals are, I think he's going to celebrate just a little bit after securing his first ever World Tour victory. Here's the last rally, and in an hour of 6 minutes, the Dane wins the men's singles final, 15-21, 21-6, 21-14.
President de la Unió de Federacions Esportives de Catalunya.
The trophy will be presented by Mr. Francesc Terron, Head of Researches of the Barcelona Sports Institute, accompanied by Mr. Gerard Esteva, President of the Catalonian Sporting Federation Union. Runner-up, segundo clasificado y finalista, de Tailandia, Suppanyu AVIHINGSANON.
Did not get his first ever tournament win, AVIHINGSANON. But some more points for the World Tour ranking and nice consolation prize.
Rasmus GEMKE, Dinamarca.
Rasmus GEMKE takes the second World Tour title for Denmark. Victor Axelsen got the first one in Malaysia Masters. Now GEMKE has done this as well. He will also better his rank on the World Tour ranking considerably.
Please give a standing ovation to both finalists of the men's single final.
Okay.
So coming up next is women's singles, the third seed, Mia Blichfeldt of Denmark against the unseeded Natsumi Tani of Japan.